Hi, everyone. If you're just joining us, welcome. This is Brett, and congratulations on turning up for the class. Hey, you registered and you turned up. That's a big deal. Well done. You actually lived up to what you promised, all right? You wanted to come. I'm going to make sure you...
And congratulations on turning up for the class. Hey, you ready?
There we go. It's good. We're going live to Facebook right now. Okay. So, hello to everybody. So, this is all about showing you what I'm doing to be able to generate around about $50,000 a month at walking pace. That could easily go to $100,000 a month. In fact, it will once I simply dial in the numbers and dial in the ads and away we go. So that can all happen. But right now I'm sort of taking it very slow. I'm operating things myself and testing and measuring everything. And so the first thing I want to tell you is that I want to tell you what's working right now, because the internet, if you haven't realized, if you've been following me for any length of time, the internet is changing dramatically, and not only dramatically, but super quick. So anything you was working, you know, 4 or 5 years ago, these days it's much, much harder to make it work. And maybe you've even experienced that yourself. Maybe you've been trying to sell an ebook, trying to sell your services, your product, your coaching, your business, whatever it is you are in the market of. And things are much harder. So there's some trends happening, which I think you should know about, being that there is so much competition now, so much competition that wasn't there 10 years ago, no way. Wasn't there 2 years ago, and I was hardly even there a 1 year ago. So everything's shifting. So you'll see a reduction in some things and a big increase in other things. Like, for instance, a lot of the trends right now are Amazon. So if you want to start a business or add to your existing business, have an Amazon business. I don't think it's a good idea at all. It's like a false profit, if you know what I mean, in that you can actually start an Amazon business. It takes time. That's no problem. You can have it all outsourced and everything, but I've got a massive issue with that as a business model, because what Amazon's doing everything for you to make it easy for you to do business, and then they're watching everybody's sales figures, all right, because they control everything. It's just like a monopoly, the way that Woolworths does, the supermarket. Anywhere there's a monopoly, they want to invite traders in so they can see what their numbers are, so they're above all the trends. So where they see the money coming in, they will then launch their own brand into that niche. So I have massive issues with the Amazon model. I'm not against you. If you're doing it, go for it. You'll make some money short term. Long term, this is not going to work. If you're selling ebooks, it's now much harder than ever before, because now there's just so much more competition. And where there's competition, prices decrease. All right. So you have to, if you're in business, you always have to work with the trends. You know that you have to work with the trends, in that you can't control the trends. You have to be able to ride the trends. So as one trend ends, another trend comes in. So obviously, I've been watching this very close to the internet. You'll see very few seminars now, the way we used to run them. Everything's shifted. And so I want to let you know what I'm doing now, fully and freely. You can ask any questions you want. But this is about you. Right now, I want you to take stock of you as a person, you as a business. And what's going to need to happen is that, because there's increased competition, it means there's a lot more players, obviously, but a lot more really skilled players. So that if you don't have any skills, we have a big problem. Used to be we could actually just release books, products, coaching programs. And because there was a big market and low supply, you make money, you generate it, you have a business. Now we have lots and lots and lots of suppliers and lots of demand, but now there's just more competition. So just that's just business, and the rules change, so you've got to change with it. So here's the way through for you if you're wanting to actually be able to have profitable internet business, profitable business in general. Firstly, you have to use the internet. The days of thinking, well, I'll just bypass it and maybe come back later, those are over. You have to have some internet portion to what you're doing. Right, that's the first thing. You've got to have some internet portion to this. It used to be an option. Now it's a necessity. This is where the world is at and where the world is going for at least the next 5 years. It's hard to see beyond 5 years, but at least for the next 5 years. But here's the bigger thing. Because there's more competition, we now need to be able to offer more value. That's how we stand out. Just pure, plain marketing concepts. So you're going to need to solve a problem. So if you are a coach, good. If you're a consultant, awesome. If you are thinking of becoming one of those, you should, right? But you've got to define what it is you're really great at. What is the problem that you solve? And it is not enough to say, well, I make people feel better. I make things easier. No, that's not what I'm talking about. We have to be specific, all right? Be specific. And so what I want to let you know is, what is the problem? What is the problem that you solve is going to be the overlying marketing strategy you're going to need to solve. What is the problem that you solve? If you don't solve a problem, you don't have a business. Where there's no void, there's no need, all right, and particularly now. So you've got to be able to solve a problem, which means you've got to be able to look at your skills, your knowledge, and your experience, which is what I call your asset. Your asset, I call that your asset. Knowledge, experience, skills, three things. You should probably write those down. That's what I call your asset. And what most people are doing, maybe you're the same, is that most people aren't leveraging the asset, okay? You aren't leveraging the asset. So the asset sits there. You have knowledge, experience, skills, which other people could benefit from. And maybe right now you're in a job, and so your employer benefits from your asset, your knowledge, experience, skills. They pay you an hourly rate or a salary, and that's where they get access to your asset. But you should always have a plan B, no matter what. But that plan B, these days, the great news about the internet, because it is expanding so fast, is that that plan B can become plan A if you do it the right way. So I want you to think about what you know. Your knowledge, experience, skills, that's your asset. And how are you leveraging that? Are you selling it as an hourly rate? If you are, that's okay. But it could be short term because you're not in charge of what happens with the asset. Your employer is, right? And so what are you doing with that asset you have between your ears? You all understand real estate as being an asset. I look at your brain and see that, and know that is the biggest asset of all. But the asset is unrealized because you may not know how to leverage it. Right? How do you actually turn that into an income, a business? Right? And it starts with saying, well, here's the problem over here, and here's my solution. Now we have a business. All right. If we have competition, then we work out, can we outcompete them? If we can, awesome. If we can't, we move on. And I'm going to tell you how to do that in a second. But there's the problem. There's the solution. If we have both of those, then I look at that and say, if I was a business investor in you, I'd say, yeah, we have a business. All right. And so that's the first thing is, you know, you need to be able to solve a problem moving forward over this year and over the next 5 years. You're going to have to solve a problem. If you do, you're thinking, okay, Brett, yeah, I solved a problem. Hello. So now let's talk about it, right? I want to talk about three things, what I call my fast client formula. Probably want to write that down. Fast client formula. Because I'll tell you what's not working so well now. What's not working as well now is low price items, okay? Because with the advent of things like Shopify and with Amazon, prices are all getting shrunk down. So we go to Amazon to get a deal, all right? And also a bit more convenient. We like Amazon because it's convenient. But anytime we're searching on any of the sites, it's like, where can I get a deal from? You know, Airbnb has gone huge because there's amazing deals, really economic deals. So prices are coming down. When competition's high, prices come down, naturally. And so where you would sell something before at a low ticket, say $0 to $50, now it's down between $0 and $10. So now it's much, much harder to make the money, all right? So that's how the market is. So what do we do about that? We have to change the whole concept in that you need to start selling what I would call high ticket, all right? There are a lot of people out there with programs, software like ClickFunnels, which is an awesome piece of software, and other types of concepts where they're telling you what you should do is give away something for free. And then as you get a lot of people giving that, you know, taking that item for free, then offer them a $47 product straight up. And for those that don't buy that, or they do buy that, then offer them a $97, and then $197, then a $297. This is called a sales funnel, right? It's called the ascension model, where the price gets larger and larger and larger. So you end up having about, you know, 1 to 10 different products. So to create those products is hard anyway, right? I always said, try and create one, and you'll be fine, right? But, you know, that whole model is about creating more and more and more. So not a big fan of that because I know the average person, perhaps like you, is going to take a long time to make all that happen. It's a lot of thinking, and most people, if you're over, say, 35 years of age, it's harder to manage the technology. It's harder to understand how to do it, and it's harder to do it. So you want to bypass that is what I would tell you to do. And the way you bypass that, and what I'm doing is that I'm going from, there is no small prices now. It goes from $3,000 as the minimum to $10,000 and higher. So your minimum price now should be $3,000. Right? And so you might be thinking, well, $3,000, how am I going to sell something for $3,000 if I can't sell something for $30? Well, I'm going to tell you how, all right, so stick with me. But your price point now needs to start at $3,000. And the reason why, more competition, so it costs more to get customers. All right, I'm talking about advertising on Facebook at the very least. It costs more to get those customers because there's more people advertising. So you don't stand out as much. You don't get as much impact. And so if you are selling things at low dollar items, then your advertising costs are going to be higher than your sale price and you're in trouble. The business doesn't work that way around. So what I want you to think of is, what is the problem that you solve in your day-to-day job? And what is the solution? Boom. That's what you're going to sell. That's going to be your asset, right? Asset. Now I'm going to tell you the fast client formula. So fast with an F, not vast, but fast. Fast client formula. Then it's only three steps. And this is how it's done, because we need to be able to take what you're doing and do it the smart way, all right? And I'm talking about showing you exactly how I do it and what I do. So the first thing is this. The marketing of whatever you do, here's step one of the fast client formula. Educational marketing, all right? Educational marketing. And so this is a system where, you know, since 2004, I've been on the internet marketing, right? I've always sprouted the same story. Start giving content, start adding value. And there's a thing there called content marketing, which is getting articles out there, videos out there, having to distribute along, you know, on many places on the internet, hoping that it builds awareness, and it does. That is a slightly slower method, but I'm okay with it. So that's good. That's great marketing, because some people just want to go straight for the sale, and that's not what I'm telling you to do. Educational marketing, which is like this right now. Right now I am educating you because I'm giving you value. You turn up to this class. I'm here in my little office. You're there at home or at your office, and you're watching me, and I'm talking, you're listening, and you should be taking notes. This is educational marketing. So anything that I'm going to tell you now is going to be worthwhile. It's going to be good. I'm promising you that. However, then what you want to think of, well, that's good. Well, how do I turn into dollars? Well, firstly, you should be doing what I'm doing right now. Using this program here called Zoom, I'm allowing you to get benefit, and I'm helping you. And so you need to be doing the exact same thing as this. And you might not have many people turn up to your webinar like I'm doing here, but at least this, you've got to start somewhere. And right now, this video is going live to you, but it's also being broadcast live to Facebook, to a group I have on Facebook, so that now people on there can watch it. And that'll be stored on Facebook, which means people can watch it, you know, like tomorrow, weeks from now, months from now, still get value from it. So educational marketing is where it should start with you. Why educational marketing? Educational marketing is there, and it's always been necessary, but it's the best tool you can use when there's lots of competition. And I'm telling you right now, there is tons of competition on the internet, as you may already know. So the obvious choice is to go for educational marketing. And what educational marketing does is it builds the trust, right? It builds the trust. And trust is everything in business. If you're going to sell anything from your business, there has to be trust between you and the customer. Otherwise, they don't buy and you don't want them as customers because there's no trust. So you've got to have trust. So educational marketing, where you truly give, like right now, I'm not giving you a sales pitch. I'm actually teaching you and telling you what to do. This is true giving, and you want to be able to do exactly the same. Whereas I see so many people, they run webinars. Maybe you've been on them too. And they talk for 20 minutes, just a whole bunch of blah, blah. And they talk about themselves, right? And then they give a little bit of content and then they do a pitch at the end. Now, I don't have an issue with that because that's how business used to be done on the internet, and it's totally fine and it still works in some instances. But the prices are decreasing with that model as well. But the point is, because there are so many people out there doing that sort of marketing, like webinars, where it's 20 minutes of blah, blah, a little bit of content, big sell, that is devaluing the thing we call webinars, the thing we're doing right now. And so the point, remember, is if you truly give and give some educational marketing, give tips and advice, freely give and actually do what you are good at, solve the problem for people with what you know, then you immediately stand out. So this is great. You immediately stand out and your marketing becomes effective. If there are so many people out there that you know that are doing BS webinars, BS ads and BS videos, then if you don't do that, then it means you're going to stand out. So this is the thing you should be saying. Thank you to all those doofuses out there who don't get it and are always trying to sell and always trying to just, you can feel they're actually truly not giving. They're just hiding behind, you know, some marketing strategies. Awesome. That's great, because you want to be the person who's not doing that and immediately you stand out. So I think it's a great strategy for that purpose. All right. So educational marketing, just like this. It involves things like doing videos, maybe starting a little Facebook group. If you don't have one already, it takes 30 seconds, it's free. Or starting a Facebook page, that's okay too. But starting to teach people, often video like this is the best. If you're not comfortable with video, that's okay too, don't worry. But you can give articles, you can write things, and education marketing is great. So this is where it's at for you. If you're wanting to succeed online from now forward, first step in my fast client formula is educational marketing. All right. So what can you give? What can you teach? What problems can you solve for free? Just totally solve the problem, teach people, stand out because you are that good. Right? And that's what it's all about. And webinars are the way, the best way doing this right now. This is awesome, right? If I wanted to, I could actually call in your video and I could talk to you and that'll be recorded too. So there's lots of options here as well. So this is what I do in my business. But what I do and what you, I want you to do too would be to progress to automated webinar, which means that the webinar, you do it once, you never have to do it again. So it gets recorded, gets put up online. For instance, the software that I use to automate my webinars is Ever Webinar, right? I have no affiliation with them. You're welcome to go and check it out and try it out. This right now is 100% live. I'm talking to you live. But often the webinars I do run, I record them once and then I automate them so that I'm now leveraging this asset. Because if I'm sitting here doing webinar after webinar after webinar, then I'm not leveraging the asset. If I can store that work away, that lesson, that those tips, that advice, that asset, and put it in a format where I'm not there, now this is good. It's automated, so people can watch it at a time that suits them, at a day that suits them, and I'm not having to do it. So this is a good one. So automated webinars are the way to go. But I'll tell you something else. When it comes to educational marketing, especially if you do these webinars where you're just going to help people, like tonight, for instance, I'm giving you three tips, and you would want to do three tips as well. Teach three things really well. Three things really well. So you don't just say give a few tips out, but you actually blow people away with what you teach them, so that your asset, your asset becomes your best marketing tool. Instead of having to think that you are have to be creative, instead of having to think that you have to learn some sales techniques, forget about that. Just help people out. Just tell them, do this, 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 and this, and stand out because of your awesome gift. But teach three things really well, to the degree where someone comes on to your webinar, and let's assume they don't know you, all right? They don't know you. Good, we assume that's going to happen. In 45 minutes, what we can do, if we teach really well, three things really well, truly give, and do nothing else but just teach. In 45 minutes, we can take you from zero to hero, all right? Which means they come on to the webinar, they don't know you from bar of soap, awesome. And as they go through your webinar, they sit there and they have these aha moments like, wow, this guy or this girl, really, I think she might be psychic. I think she might actually know me. Because that's how I feel. Or that's what happens in my business. Oh, I can't believe this person actually knows how I'm feeling and what's going on. And this is the brand building, the credibility building, the excitement building that can happen for your business in just 45 minutes through an automated webinar. All right. And so this is the key. By really teaching, really helping, then this is what happens. This transformation happens where people come onto your webinar and say, I don't know, who is this person? By the end of it, saying, I've got to talk to this person. In just 45 minutes, all right? So there's no blabber at the start and there's no pitch at the end either. So this is the future from here on in. No pitch at the end. But what you will do at the end is as you teach three things really well, blow them away, you will offer them a gift at the end and that will be a chance to talk to you, right? You might call that a discovery call, a breakthrough session, a strategy call, whatever you want to do. But this allows people to be able to choose to come and sit with you and deal with you and learn more from you. All right, this is the first step of my fast client formula is educational marketing, and step number two of my fast client formula is start with an appointment. All right, so the first tip is educational marketing. The second tip is start with an appointment. All right, this is how it works. So what you want to do is, you know, often with the internet, and some people are still, preaching this method and it's outdated and because everything's shifted, right? But you want it all automated. No, you don't want it all automated because everybody's wanting to automate everything online. You want to be the one who doesn't automate it so you stand out instantly. So a phone call is a great way to do it. And the offer, of course, is, you know, sometimes you can be doing this sort of stuff via Facebook. Like you can be messaging on Facebook, you know, personal messaging there, private messaging there. You could have three or four conversations going at once. You could actually offer and sell them, tell them or help them first and then offer your services afterwards. And that's a great way. You could have that all happening online, right? But I think you'll find that the best way for you to be able to sell something at a high ticket is definitely be able to help people in person, because it's so rare, right? So rare. So the first part of this formula is educational marketing, right? We take your asset, we start using it as the advertising tool. We help people on a webinar generally, 45 minutes, three things really well, and boom. The next step is to start with an appointment where you can actually get on the phone ideally, or even on video like this if you want to as well, and just actually communicate with people, all right? So you think about the problem that you solve. You've just given them a webinar where you've taught them three things that should help solve that. And if they want more information, then they can come and get you and talk to you on the phone. But that's where you can blow people away by actually helping again, all right? Yeah, helping again. But this little idea of educational marketing, and then secondly, an appointment, you know, appointment to enroll. This is a hoop that people have to jump through, okay? So A, they had to, you know, click on an ad which led them to your webinar, and then they had to then register for, you know, appointment with you. And so these are little hoops that people are jumping through. So as people jump through them, they get more and more serious and committed. And obviously some people don't jump through them, and that's good because we are now pushing away the interested and attracting the committed. You should write that down. Push away the interested and attract the committed. And I'm going to show you at the end of this webinar here where I'm going to offer to work with you for free as well. I'm going to show you how this all works. All right. So educational marketing, and then start with an appointment. And that appointment is where you can find out and talk directly to your prospect to find out what their problem is, all right, what their problem actually is. And this is really key because it's like people won't buy if they don't think you understand who they are, what their problems are, how they feel. So in a phone call, at the very least, is a way for you to actually start that process of saying, well, let me find out what's going on. What's the problem? What are you experiencing right now? Let's see if I can help you. And so this is what I'm doing in my business as well. And what happens is that I get to listen. Firstly, this is great. But then I get to help. So I help on the actual phone call. And then if I feel that client's right, and if they feel it's right, it becomes obvious that maybe there's an option we should probably work together. And if we're not a good match, that's okay too. So we openly go into this knowing, well, you only want to be able to work with the right clients. Because I tell you what, we are only ever 30 seconds away from being trashed online, okay? Someone just, these days, anybody can go online, make a comment on Facebook, they can go online to a blog, they can address almost any site out there, say what they like, there's no consequences, no checking the facts and figures, and they can say whatever they like. So you're at a disadvantage. As a business owner, you're at a disadvantage now, a great disadvantage, because there's no comeback, there's no fighting back, because you only look like a bigger idiot if you fight back. So this is all weighted in the customer's favor. So what do we do about that? What I want you to do now is that, you know, often in the past, I would have allowed anybody to join my programs, as long as they want to do enough, and they were committed, join, let's go. And these days I just don't do that, right? So this is another tip for you to start to think about, is that you want to stand guard at the door of your any product or service you offer. You want to stand guard. Because I tell you why, you only want to work with the committed, right? You want to work with the committed, not the interested. It's the interested who don't truly buy into what you do, who don't see the value in what it is you do. And then that, if they aren't committed to what you do, then you become the victim of their ability to not take responsibility, all right? You become the person they blame. So stand guard in the future at who gets into your programs, who you help. This could just be a business transaction. And if you're these, you know, if I go to the local accountant and I decide that I want to use them, they take me on, right? And that's the business of the old way. That's the old way of doing business, because that's business in the 80s and 90s, right? The future is where the business owner actually gets to decide, well, hold on, do I want to deal with this person, right? So it is a decision between, well, do I want the money first or do I want the quality client first? And this one here is going to be the long-term option. If you get a really good client and they're committed and they do as you help them to do, then they're going to get great results. Awesome results. Then they're going to tell other people about you. It'll happen naturally, which will bring you more quality clients. So there's a way of growing this business organically by choosing the good ones, the most committed, who actually do what you say, leaving the ones that won't, that have hesitations, questions, doubts, cynicism, whatever. And this is now the way of the future of business, because you are only about 30 seconds away from being trashed online. And people, the public, likes to believe the negative stuff and not the positive stuff. They trust the negative stuff. They don't trust the positive stuff. All right. They think the positive stuff's a sales pitch. They think the negative stuff's the truth. So you got to make sure that you avoid that as much as possible. And I've been bitten by that as well, by people who don't want to take responsibility, want to be able to point the finger. So that doesn't happen anymore. I stand at the gate to my nightclub, so to speak, to make sure I get the best in. So step number one is education and marketing. Step number two is start with an appointment so that you can vet your clients, so you can help them, start the relationship, increase the trust, but also come to a situation where they want to work with you and you want to work with them. This is going to be the long-term strategy. There's two strategies of business. There's short-term and there's long-term. Short-term you can do. Long-term you can do. One, you only want one of them, and it is long-term. And I'm sure, when I say that, I'm sure you're going, yeah, I think I agree, right? But often we get tempted by the cash. Go for the quality every single time. So now I'm going to give you a little tip here about when you're on that appointment. There is something more important than anything you're selling, all right? So often when you create a coaching program or you're trying to sell your services or your product, whatever it is, all you're thinking about is your product or your service, okay? All you think about is the product or the service. And so all you want to tell people about, prospect about, is your product or service. Oh, wait till you see this. I've got this. I've got that. And we have to then look into the sales psychology of what's really going on, in that that's how you want to sell it, but it's not always how the customer wants to buy it, because the customer really doesn't care a whole lot about your product or your service. Right? What do they care about? What they care about is the end result, the outcome, what it is they're going to get out of it. And it isn't that you have a beautiful office and company cars, and it isn't that you have lots of videos to watch, but they're important to you, but not to the end consumer, right? And so once you realize the psychology here is, you know, if I'm a customer, I don't really want to have what you've got, but I want the outcome that helps me get. Right? So, for years and years, I've sold, you know, DVDs and manuals. But I hardly ever talked about that, because that wasn't what people wanted. It wasn't what they were actually buying for. What they were buying for was to reach an outcome. And so once you realize what people buy, what they buy, why they buy, then it's much easier for you to work out how you're going to sell it. So don't be like everybody else out there. Like if you go into Facebook right now, you will see lots of ads that are sending you to webinars where they are pitching you on the webinar, selling their product or their service. You've seen them, you've been on them, I'm pretty sure. And so the conversion rate's going down and down and down and down. Because why? Because that's not how people want to buy when there are so many other choices. So you have to shift with the market. And so what you want to do is you want to be able to choose who you sell to, and your customers be able to sell who they buy from, all right? But you've got to be cool about it. And how you be cool about it is educational marketing, and then start with an appointment where you can actually truly communicate and have a relationship. But of course, what I'm telling you is your price needs to be higher than chances are what it is right now. You want to have prices between $3,000 and $10,000. This is for you to survive, okay? If you want to enter the mass market, become another massive big corporate company out there, then you lower your prices so you can get bigger market share. But I'm suspecting that's not what you really want to do, and I suspect it's not really possible for you too. It might be possible, but it's unlikely, all right? No matter who you are, it's going to be a hard road. So what we do is we have less clients. What if we had less clients, less work to do because they're at a higher price? And it's like, you know, often a $20 product gives people a $20 solution. Let's say you've written a book, or you've made an audio or a video, and you want to try and sell it for $5.95 or $20, whatever you want to sell for. But it means that because people are paying so little money, there's only so much time you can give customers when they're at a low ticket. All right? Makes sense, right? Whereas if I give you a $20 solution, but you really need a much bigger solution where there's more time, more commitment, more teaching, more education, more everything involved, then I need to charge you a higher price so that I can get you to where you want to go. It's like you might buy 200 ebooks, but if you don't read them, you don't act on them, then it's been a waste of your money no matter what, right? But what if you could just make one investment and get the actual solution? So, you know, over the years, I've spent thousands on training. I've spent thousands on speeding things up, right? Speeding things up. And what I'm doing is I'm paying for data. I'm paying for results. I'm speeding things up. But you're going to need to get good value if the price has been high, because then you can ask questions. Then you can get the one-on-one help if you need it. Then you can get the detail if you need it. The constant revision. This is what it takes to have a really good coaching consulting business. And I'm going to suggest to you right now, if you've never thought about doing any coaching or consulting, you must, you should. Take what you have right now. Take this asset, this knowledge, experience, and skills, and think how can I help people? What problems are out there that I know I could help with? All right. And you turn it into a coaching business, but not something at $49, not something even at $500, but something starting at $3,000. That's where you need to start, because competition is high. It'll take you more, a bigger investment to get the prospects on board if we need more margin in your sale price. So if you've never thought that what you do is worth $3,000, then we need to have a talk and we need to actually show you how and why it can happen. But it's like some people say, Brett, I'm a counselor. I only help people do X, Y, Z. I help them stop eating bad food, you know. And someone like me looks at that and go, well, hold on a second. What are the consequences? What's the real outcome of training somebody how to eat the right food? What's the real outcome? All right. And the real outcome is more likely to be something like better health, potentially a longer life, less illness, more energy. And this could be for life. So just with you teaching somebody X, Y, Z, if it's really good transformational stuff, which takes them from where they are to where they want to be, often I'll call this hell and I'll call that paradise. If what you do can take somebody from their hell to a version of paradise, then that's what people will invest in to get that result. So that suddenly if you're a dietitian, you're not a dietitian anymore. If you're a personal trainer, you're not a personal trainer. You are in the business of transforming people's lives in a certain area. And often they can use those skills forever. So the bottom line is it's a lot of awesome value. And people will happily invest, you know, high ticket program to get the result they want. Can you just help me? So the big key to that appointment, I'll get back to this tip now. I was about to give you about the appointment. The big tip is that it's not about your product or your service. It's all about having clients that want to change, all right? That's the most important thing. Not about your product or service or how good the product or service is. It's do your clients actually want to change what they're doing, where they're going? And if you can't help convince them that they need to do that, then you're not going to get a sale, bottom line. But if they come to you really motivated, or if they come to you unmotivated and you help them get motivated, that's when we have transformation. That's when we have an opportunity for you to solve their problems in the right way. If someone pays you a high ticket price, you can invest the time, the money to do it properly. And so this is the key. It's all about this really big secret here is you've got to help people realize they need to change. Not about helping people to realize they need to buy your product. So all the webinars you go on and you see, they're all trying to sell the product. It's a big mistake. What they should be doing is helping you to realize how much you need to change. And what I'm trying to help you realize now is you need to change. You need to change how you're doing business in general. Because it's so important, everything, the whole rules have changed. So start with an appointment. Educational marketing. Start with an appointment. And then the third strategy I want to give you in terms of what I'm doing to generate about $50,000 a month, and this is in coaching sales where people are investing with me for me to show them actually how to actually attract clients, have an automated business, have it all working and generate, you know, $50,000 to $100,000 a month. That's what I do. That's my specialty. So the third part of this fast client formula is to coach groups, not individuals. All right. Help groups, not individuals. And often if you have some skills, some knowledge, you have an asset, often you get tricked into thinking, well, I've got to become a consultant. I need to work one-on-one with clients. It needs to be face-to-face. No, not true. Not true. You can, but that's a really poor model. And I'll tell you various reasons why one-to-one is a poor model. Firstly, it's not scalable. So if I was to throw throw you 20 clients right now and you work with them one-on-one, you'd be overwhelmed, all right? You'd have trouble actually servicing them all. So it would take you ages to get that all worked out, just 20 clients. So therefore, your business is very weak in that you'll happily do the work, but if there's too many, overwhelmed. So it's a big problem. Whereas a lot of people are held up as consultants. Wow, you're a consultant. It sounds so great. It's terrible. It's not the model you want at all. And so you want a coach group. So for instance, right now, I am talking to you right here at home. You can hear me and you can see me, but I'm also talking to everybody else on this call as well. So I'm teaching you without having to be right beside you, without having to be in the same office. I'm teaching you, right? And so this is very, very powerful. And if I wanted to, I could open up the cameras and we could talk one-to-one. So it can all be done. But teaching groups is what you want to aim for. Whatever you're doing right now, you want to ask yourself, how can I teach this in a group? How can I teach this to a group? How can I make what I know universal so that anybody can take advantage of it and want to be able to use it and learn from it? So you look at examples like Tony Robbins is brilliant at this. So he talks and teaches thousands of people at once. And so he's learned how to teach the knowledge. He teaches principles so that then you can go away, take the principles and apply them to your problem, right? So this is sort of stuff you want to model. How can you take what you do and what you know and teach groups? So get out of the one-to-one and instead teach groups. So for what I do, I have a program called Fast Client Formula where I teach my folks as groups. I run live Q&As once a week where they can ask any question they want. I'm here, they're there, I can see them, they can see me. And I can help them one-on-one in that setting, but it's all put into 1 hour per week. So it's highly leveraged now from the business point of view, but the customer also gets value too. And I've run these Q&As from Mexico, for instance. So I don't have to be here in Australia. I can be anywhere in the world. And I'm still able to help people. And I'm taking questions one-to-one, but everyone's there in the one group. Right? So this is what you want to be able to do too. But something else you can do too is you can use the tool Facebook. You can start a Facebook group. It takes 30 seconds to create. It's free. And it means that only your clients get access to that group. And they can ask you any question there they want. So they would log in. And you log in once a day as the organizer, the expert, and maybe 15 minutes a day, answer a couple of questions, like a couple of comments, and you're out. And from their point of view, this is awesome because they're getting you answering their questions. They love this. So, wow, I just typed a question in. An XYZ person, you, has come back to them and actually answered your question. This is like, wow, I feel so special, right? And so there's actually another benefit too, that if you answer a question in a group, the rest of the group gets to see the question and the answer. So now you've answered for that person, but you've also answered it for everybody else. So we have a great community here. If you truly work hard at giving, at truly giving, then what happens is you will create a community that wants to help as well. So if you're in there truly giving, you're giving, you'll get all your students wanting to help as well and actually wanting to impress you with how they're helping others in the group too. So this is what a community is all about. And people don't want to be part of another Facebook group, but they do want to be part of a community. We love groups as humans, like-minded groups who are on the same journey as us, in which we can help each other, and it's an awesome community of trust and of helping. And this is where it's at for you, okay? So in terms of how to actually create a coaching program, that would be a topic for a whole nother day. But remember this formula, my fast client formula is educational marketing, start with an appointment and then go to group coaching. This is the formula that I use to generate around $50,000 a month. And I'm about to ramp that up to about $100,000 a month. I can just dial in the numbers and be able to do that. So very powerful. So I'm not trying to impress you. I'm letting you know what I'm doing so that you can start and think about doing this yourself because the internet has changed forever. And now what I can do, I've been talking now for about 40 minutes. I promise you a 45-minute class. If there are questions, I will take them now. If you'd like to ask me questions, you can. Bill's asking a question here. How do you effectively manage the one-on-one appointments in Strategy 2? There are only so many hours in the day we can dedicate to unbilled hours. Yeah, good one. So Bill's asking, how do you run all these appointments? So how I do it is that in a second you're going to get a chance to go make an appointment with me. I'm going to give you a gift. And it's going to be totally, there's no agenda. I'm just going to help you out. but you're going to use some software and you're going to make an appointment at a time that I've predetermined. So I'm totally in charge of when they happen. And it's about a bill you're worried about, you know, unbilled hours. The problem with that thinking is that you're thinking of billing by the hour. No, you want to bill for the result. Whenever you bill for the result, that's where everything changes, because billing by the hour, you'll end up working for too little, okay? Whereas billing for a result, say between $3,000 and $10,000 to achieve a result and to actually coach people like in groups of that amount. So everyone's paying $3,000 to $10,000 getting into a group. Now we can forget about the billable hours and we have about whatever time we want. In fact, I only work around about 10 hours a week. Today, I did two calls, and the rest of the time I'm just doing whatever I want. So I can go home, I can play on the internet, I can create more stuff, but it's total freedom because of the model. The model's very important, right there, Bill. And so if you were to do, let's say you want to earn $50,000 a month, right? Do you want to do that? Everybody want to earn $50,000 a month? Here's what you're going to do. Earn $50,000 a month and your product price is $3,000. How many clients do you need? Somebody do the maths. If you want to make $50,000, how many clients do you need if your price is $3,000? Somebody type it into the chat box, see if you're awake. I'm waiting. I don't see the answer, come on. 16 to 17 says Bill, thank you. 17 says Narelle, well done. 16.6 is someone Wendy's answer, well done. Let's say it's 17. So you just need 17 clients. That's all you need is per month, 17 clients, and you're on $50,000 a month. Now, 17 clients, depending on how good you are on the phone, depending how well matched up you are with your prospects, you might only need to do 17 calls a month, right, in order to get the 17 clients. Probably a little bit more. Maybe if you did 30 calls a month and you're closing one in two, then you're doing 30 calls a month. It's spread out over a month, right? So, for instance, you could spread out 30 calls over 4 weeks, which is around about maybe 7 calls a week. So 7 calls a week, let's say. If you could do 7 phone calls a week, and what I try and aim for is to do 10 a week, right? The goal you want to get to is about 10 calls a week, appointments a week where you can really talk to your prospect. And if you were to close 3 out of 10, enroll about 3 out of 10, you're going to do three clients a week at $3,000, that's $9,000 a week. You're going to hit around about $36,000 a month. So it's not the $50,000, but $36,000 for just doing 10 calls a week. All right. And that's where a lot of the work comes from. So with whatever I do, I'm working between 10 hours definitely, up to 15 hours just on doing this system. And that's including the Q&A, answering the Facebook questions, and then doing these appointments where I find and I search for and only accept really good clients. All right. So that's all very good, all right? So it works really well. So hopefully, Bill, that helps you out. All right, so somebody's asking, Dylan's asking about this in the chat column. Let me see what you're asking here. Dylan, hold on. You're talking about when people are, you're answering questions on a weekly group basis. So you're thinking maybe only 2 or 3 questions can be addressed. Not true. Often I'll do my Q&A for maybe an hour, maybe an hour and 15. And I'll answer as many questions as come my way. Because often what you should be doing, when I talk to my group, I'll categorize the questions. So I'll, if you're in week 1 to week 4, ask now. If you're in week 4 to week 8, ask now. If you're past week 8, you know, so I have these groups that I can answer questions from. But the way we do it is that if someone asks a question, the other folks are listening and they get help from that as well. So you're actually reducing questions. But what happens is as you get more consistent questions, if the same question comes up week after week, you go back into your training, answer that question in your training, that question never happens again. So it's a great way to create any sort of program to do this Q&A. All right. So I'm trying to look through some of your questions here to see if I can help you out. Good one. I'm just looking over here. Well, I'm looking at this because that's where I can see the chat column. All right. So somebody's asking, where do I find my clients? Good. Well done. So where I find them is on Facebook. Facebook is your best marketing tool right now. The Facebook advertising product is the best product going for advertising. Google is good. Facebook is great. The targeting you can do is we can place an ad, boom, right in front of your target market, right in front of your target market, which means we can eliminate all the folks who are not in your target market, right? So we reduce our advertising costs. Let me give you some tips on the 2 ways to write an ad. You don't need to be creative. But two ways to write a really good ad for Facebook is to do one of two things. Either focus on a problem that they are experiencing, or a problem, you know, your market's experiencing, or an emotion they are feeling. All right, two ways to write an ad. Problem they're experiencing, an emotion they're feeling. So if someone goes through their Facebook feed, they're on their phone and they're scrolling, yeah, boom. They see your ad and they should say something like, hey, hold on a second, that's me. That's exactly how I'm feeling. That's exactly what I'm going through. All right. And that's how we make advertising and Facebook profitable, is we write the ad, not creatively, but understandingly, if that's even a word, but it's about understanding the market, what they're going through. And when they go through that, then we put them through a process after that. So Facebook is the number one tool. I did not like anything else at this point. I'm not saying that would change. That could change month by month. But at this point, Facebook is an absolutely brilliant tool for anyone to market with. All right. So I can see a whole lot of people here are enjoying it and typing in questions. I think I've answered that one. And so what I'm going to do is this. Would you like to talk to me personally? Would you like to talk to me personally at no cost? I'm going to offer a bonus here to anybody who is on this call, and you'd like to talk to me personally. I can sort of delve into your situation. So here's the deal. I will help you. This is what I do. I've been doing it since 2004. But you've got to be serious. You've got to be committed. You've got to say, you've got to be somebody who says, all right, I so want this. Like, I want to change my results online. I want to actually get some sales. I want to get out of my job. I want to be able to earn $50,000 a month, Brett. I want to be able to have that freedom to go on holidays. I'm sick of this. I'm sick of that. That's what you need to be. That's who you need to be. Then I know if I'm going to talk to you, then I can really help you. If you're not committed, that's okay. Come back another day. All right, come back when you are committed. Otherwise, it's a waste of your time, a waste of mine. And I'll find it out in the first 10 minutes either way, all right, whether you're committed or not. So if I'm going to help you, I need you to be committed. But if you'd like to do that, in a second, I'm going to give you a website address to go to. Happily help you out. Why am I doing this? Well, because this is how I find really good clients. If we are a good match, then it's going to become obvious that if we work together, you're going to get your end goal. If we don't work together, you might get another way. I don't really mind. I'm not here to convince anybody of stuff they don't want to do. But if we find that we're a good fit, then you might want to become a client. If you do, my rates start at $1,000 per month, right? So go into this with your eyes open. I'll happily help you on the call. But if we're a match, be ready to invest in coaching. Don't be one of these doofuses who think, you place no value on coaching. You place no value on someone helping you getting there faster and sooner. If you don't place any value on it, don't even do the call, all right? I'll give you the address here in a second. But if you do and realize there's a faster way, that even Tiger Woods has a coach, even all the top tennis players have coaches, there's a reason why a coach can get you there, because they've been there and made mistakes, then I'm going to give you a website to go to in a second. Get on. And so here we go, right? So if I was to waste your time, let's just assume that what I'm saying is not true, because some people have doubts and cynicism. All right, whatever. If you think I've wasted your time, I'm going to send you $50 as a gift from me for wasting your time, because time is one of the most valuable commodities we have. And I want to make sure you know this is not going to waste your time. I'm going to help you on the call. I'm going to tell you what the big problem is you're facing. I'm going to listen to you, find out what the problem is you're facing. I'm going to tell you how to solve it. Then I'll give you a step-by-step plan of what to do about it. All right? So if anything I've said here interests you so far in this call, and you're thinking, I don't know how the hell I'm going to do it, Brett. Good, get on a call. I'll tell you exactly how, and I'll create a plan just for you, okay? And if you don't think I'm worth it, you don't think you've had a good time, I'll happily send you $50 as just my way of repaying you for your time. It's my way of assuring you, right? So here's what's going to happen. I'm going to give you a website to go to. Here it is. Grab your pen and write this down. It is brettmcfall.com. So my name.com, brettmcfall.com. /session, all right, /session. So what I'm going to do, let me see what I can do here. Let me see if I can just share this whiteboard. I'll give you the exact address. You should be able to see my screen. There it is there, okay. What I'm saying sounds good to you, brettmcfall.com/session. Go there right now. It'll allow you to book in. When you do, you'll choose a time and a date that I'm available. And then we're going to meet on the phone, right? I'm going to help you. Pardon me. I'm going to help you out. I'm going to find out what your problem is. I'm going to show you how to solve it. I'm going to outline a step-by-step plan. And I'm either going to send you on your way, or I'm going to say, you know what, maybe we should look at doing something together. And if you do, great. If not, that's okay too. But I'll work out whether that's actually going to be a good idea, and you can work it out as well. brett-mcfall.com/session, and that will get you everything you need to be able to talk to me in person. So if what I'm saying here makes sense, jump on it, do it. There are only so many sessions I do per week. As I said, I do 10 a week. That's going to go pretty quick from this call, I'm sure you can imagine, right? And as more people watch the recordings, then it's more people are going to be doing this as well. But this is my offer to help you out. I'm here doing educational marketing so you can realize there is a better way. And in fact, whatever you've been doing up till now will not work going forward. There has to be a change. You have to shift what you're doing. And if you don't know how to do it, I'm going to help you do it. All right? So go to that website right now, brett-mcfall.com/session, and I will help you out. Okay. Let me see if I can just answer any last questions here for you as well. I'll stop sharing the screen. That way it should be just me. There we go. And it says any chats. All right. All right, Mike Irwin, you're liking my haircut? Yep, I do what I can every single day. Appreciate it. All right, so if you want to do that, hopefully this has helped you out. I want to get you thinking about what you're doing. You need to change, right? From this point forward, you need to change how you're doing what you're doing. I'm willing to help you do that. Hopefully this call's been the start of that, and then maybe even I can show you how to create your product. How the hell can you charge between $3,000 and $10,000? How can you do that? I'm going to tell you exactly how, all right? I'll explain the whole thing. But come with some skills. Come with a solution to a problem so you actually know, I know you actually can do something, and I'm going to help you out, all right? So that's my offer to you. No charge on that at all. No obligation. I won't hassle you after it, but that's how I work, all right? All right. So I see a lot of questions coming in, but that's my 45 minutes up. In fact, I've been going for 52 minutes. So I like to keep my promise. I don't want to. Now you can go away. You can go and watch TV or whatever you want to do. But jump on that website, brett-mcfall.com/session, and I will help you out. Looking for a call. If you're really quick, you'll get it pretty soon. If not, then you might have to wait a week or two. So the sooner you do that, the better. All right. But until next time, if you've enjoyed this, I'm Brett McFall. It's been an honor to have you with me and be able to teach you this on this class. And I look forward to seeing you maybe on a call. I'll see you somewhere else online soon, all right? So until then, take care, folks. Well done. Appreciate it. Hope you enjoyed that. Take care.